will happen in the least possible time, and that action plan is being already worked out. So I think in the next few weeks time we'll be announcing that how soon we'll be able to register a patent in India. Second part is law, administration, and the second part of that is enforcement. Because law is as good as it is enforced. You can make a law and not enforce, there's no law. And therefore, we believe that enforcement is going to be a critical part. And therefore, I'm very happy that most of the agencies which are related to enforcement are present here, either nationally or globally. There's also Interpol, which looks at it globally, and nationally, all of our police forces who are interested with this responsibility of enforcing all kinds of law. But I think to sensitize them, the need to bring in IPR is one of the key components of enforceability. We must recognize that, I think that will explain why we have to enforce it more, particularly I am talking to my police friends. See, when you get sick, you want a medicine. And if the medicine is not developed, you'll never get cured. For medicine to get developed, you need intellectual property right. Otherwise, no medicine will get developed. So then you can imagine, and particularly I can see my young women officers here, your child needs medicine, and a mother can understand it better than anybody else, the importance of a child's health. And therefore, medicine is very critical for cure, and development of medicine is first and foremost critical part of that is IPR. If you don't have IPR, you will not get it. Now the second part, and this is what enforceability comes in, is we should ensure that there are no fake drugs. There are no counterfeit drugs. There are no spurious drugs. And that is why enforceability will become extremely important, because we are playing with the lives of people. And that's one part. The second part is, of course, as our Excellency and his friends will be interested, that when you get foreign direct investment to India, many times it comes with technology. Or even if somebody licenses a technology without getting FDI attached to it, all this technology has also been developed by somebody using his intellectual property. And therefore, he has a right to develop it. For example, our Indian films, which are made in India and Bollywood, if that is pirated, we feel very bad that, you know, the producer has spent so much of money and he is not getting it. The same way, a person who has developed an idea, concept, a product, and it gets violated, his right gets violated and infringed, then obviously he will also feel bad. So therefore, protecting that property right, whether it is made in India or it is imported into India, has to be very seriously honored. And again, I'll explain to the need for protecting IPRs coming from abroad. We may feel this is abroad, why we should do it? All economic development in India, and all of us again are going to have children, and children's job is very important for us, next generation is important for us. All of that depends upon economic development. Economic development depends upon investments. Investment in India will not be sufficient to get 9-10% growth rate that we are aspiring for unless we get foreign direct investment. Foreign direct investment, therefore, will create jobs, will create new technology, will create new products, which will make our life easier. But to do that, if you don't protect the intellectual property right, why would somebody bring it to India? And therefore, we must understand the linkage. It is not because the European Union is telling us we have to do it, not because somebody else is telling us, this is in our own interest of India that we have to protect this right. And therefore, it's the responsibility of all the police officers to ensure that we protect it. It's also responsible of my ministry to administer it properly. But law has to be administered. But law is administered but not enforced. So all the three components, unless they are aligned at the same time, will not get a desired result. Other we can say we have made a good law, but nothing will happen out of it. As I wish to always say when I was a Minister of Environment, that environment, we are the best laws in the country. Well, best. At par, some of the countries have come to me when I was Environment Minister to find out how you make these laws. Because particularly when we are making law on biodiversity. This was the only country other than India which had made law on biodiversity was Costa Rica, after the Biodiversity Convention. So there was no precedent, nothing to follow. So we made our own law by like this. We called all the top different stakeholders who are completely opposed to each other. There are people who are human rights people who feel biodiversity should be protected for people, and there are animal rights people who feel all the humans should be taken out of forest. And despite that, we made the law by getting all these different conflicting stakeholders. Why I'm saying this is law, if it is made, it is good. But if it is not enforced, what is the use of law? It's a piece of paper. And therefore, enforceability of law, whether domestic or our international commitment, is an extremely important thing that enhances the country's reputation. You may not imagine any one violation in India on IPR made by any officer somewhere is going to create a bad image for India. And therefore, it is an important responsibility, all of you, that you are really speaking the flag bearers of India. You have to ensure that it is properly implemented, enforced, and enforced in spirit, not just by letter. So you must understand it. And therefore, you must be sensitized. I always feel also sorry for my police brothers and sisters because there are so many things to do, so many laws to administer. So I understand your difficulty. So we please tell us what type of support you need from the ministry. We'll be able to provide you the modules of how to implement the law, how to enforce the law. I think we should, today we have called the people, but I think what I will request the secretary, that we should call all the DG police, all the law enforcement people, particularly maybe additional DG who is in charge of law enforcement or something like this to Delhi. Prepare a module for them, because not one time event is enough. Prepare a proper module for implementation. What is a violation? How it happens? How to track it? How to prosecute? Because prosecution is another important thing. See, enforcement is not just catching a person. Ultimately, for the crime he has committed, if he is not convicted, the catching has no meaning. And therefore, conviction will depend upon the kind of evidence you collect, kind of prosecution you are able to launch. And that all would need a lot of expertise. And therefore, I will not only say that you do this, we'll give you all the support. I think that's what we must do. Prepare good modules for them, and on an ongoing basis, probably even online modules. So when you want to know something, you should be able to download it. You can go through the computer and say, I want to see the crime, somebody has made a complaint. How to track it? Go through the module, find out how it's, what section, what rules, what has been violated, how it has been violated. What type of evidence you must collect, because this is a completely different kind of crime. See, normally our police agencies are very good in catching a person who is a murderer or a thief, because they are trained to that. But it's a different crime. Slowly, we had a white collar crimes, which are bank frauds and others, so there are some economic offenses. But this is a completely different kind of offense. This is actually intellectual crime. So this is a different crime. This is not just a moral crime, it is a moral crime, but also intellectual crime. Sometimes if somebody says, and this always happens, even in the European Union this happens. The Google will say, we have not violated the law. Whereas the European Union say, no, you have violated the law. So this is very difficult to prove. And therefore, I think we must work very closely. And I must say, and I would like to assure the whole world, that India is fully committed, not only for the intellectual property regime to be created, which we have done, but also implement it, administer it, enforce it, prosecute the violators, and ensure that justice is being done to the person who has been developer of an intellectual property. And this is our own interest. Try to understand. Now it's not that India is the only country which only imports IPR. India has now become a country which exports IPR. We are now in the forefront of one of the knowledge economies of the world, and going to be even more as we go and advance in the future. So in our own interest, some of our police officers' children, I'm sure, will become scientists. And if they develop a product, and then they come and tell the father or the mother, see, I developed it, and somebody in our neighborhood in some other country has violated it, and they are using it as their product. What will you feel about it? Just imagine, forget all this. I'll give a simple example. When a child goes to school and writes a very good essay, so teacher says, fantastic essay. But the awardee declared, he said, this is the essay on mother, for example. The essay is written on mother. So teacher reads the essay, says, what a beautiful essay this mother has been written. So the person who has actually written it is feeling happy now. His name is going to be announced, and he's going to go to stage to receive the award. But teacher announces somebody else's name. He said, oh, how did it happen? I wrote the essay. But he didn't realize that somebody else was copying it. And he sent it to the teacher before him. So teacher thought it is an essay written by him. What will feel as a father or the parent of a child when this is being done? What will be the child's heartbroken child will feel about it? I think that is what is going to happen even in commercial terms. when long-term investment goes into IPR, they are not properly protected. So I think we must do all this. I wish you all the best. I think European Union is India's great partner, trading partner, civilizational partner, cultural partner, and now he's telling me even airline partner.
Yes.
So I think we'll work with you very closely, and we'll definitely make sure that European Union becomes, continues to be our not only partner but a good friend, and we'll look forward to doing that. So all the best to you. I think we must try to enforce it as much as possible. Congratulations.
The kickoff is to get the entire collective human experience made better by munching on crisp popcorn and hot samosas as you settle into your seat. When was the last time you enjoyed such an evening basking in this kind of a glorious cinematic experience? Cinema's conception in itself lies on this very principle of warmth and togetherness. Indulging in piracy through easy illegal downloads brutally robs us of this very experience that cinema was created for. Let's come together and pledge to stop piracy.